So today we'll be continuing computer graphics, and today we'll be seeing colored CRT device displays, and there are two methods for it. So beam penetration method, and the next one is a shadow penetration method. So first we'll see beam penetration method. The way it works is that suppose we have the phosphor screen we had, and it consisted of red. This one known as, it is known as the outer layer, and it is coated as red, and this one is known as the inner layer, or it is coated as green. Okay, so basically what happens, the electron beam that was coming, so it was, if it was coming at a slow or less intensity, so it would hit the red plate and only we could see the red color being generated. And if we further increase the speed and acceleration, so that it would hit the green also, and as a result we could see the green. And on variation of intensity of the electron beam, we could generate other colors also, like yellow, orange. And this is how the beam penetration method works. So fast beam electron will generate green, and slow will generate red, and a combination of them will generate different colors. So as you can see, the speed of the electrons and the screen at any point is controlled by the acceleration voltage. Okay, the speed is important. And the beam penetration method is used for random scan monitors, and only four colors are possible: red, green, orange and yellow. The quality picture is not as good as the other of methods. So this was all about beam penetration method. The next method we have is known as the shadow masking method. So basically what happens, the electron gun, this consists of three guns, that is of blue, this is blue, this is green and this is red. So the electron beam will generate, and this is known as a shadow mask, or it is also known as metal sheet. This is used for controlling the intensity of these electron guns. Okay, so electron guns intensity is controlled from this shadow mask or metal sheet. And after like going through this metal plate, on the phosphor screen we'll get a pixels or dots. So basically what happens, this as a circle in a one pixel, it will have red, blue and green color in it. So this is also known as 3 phosphor, because it contains RGB, that is green and blue. And it is, and we can see that it will be generated as a triangle, because see, triangle is generated. So it is also known as a dot triangle. Okay, and by this, since we can generate red, blue and green, we could generate like many colors from it, and this would generate a much focused image. And this is known, this triangle is also known as, sometimes called as delta, so you can also remember that also. So basically this is mostly used as CRT displays or CRT systems, because much focused and brighter image is formed. So this was all about beam penetration method and shadow masking method. So thanks for watching it.